We're following breaking news tonight. We have just learned the names of the police officers involved in the shooting of two suspects on Highway 212 in Eden Prairie.
We also have new details about the next step in the investigation. Plus, we talked to the family of the woman shot and killed. First, these are the names of the four officers involved. They're currently on administrative leave, which is standard. They are Chaska Police Sergeant Brady Jewell and Chaska Police Officer Trent Wirtz. Both have at least 14 years with the department. Corporal Nathan Mueller, a 9-year veteran with the Carver County Sheriff's Department, and State Patrol Trooper Mark Lund, a 14-year veteran. We also have new details about what happened that day. Our Beth McDonough joins us live now from BCA headquarters in St. Paul with all the breaking developments. Beth?
Well, Ellen, all of those officers spent the better part of their day here at the BCA, the Bureau of Criminal Apprehension, which is the state's top law enforcement agency here. And from these interviews, we've learned a number of things. The couple in the car, Matthew Service and Don Pfister, they were driving a stolen car from Colorado, so this couple was on the run. And when that car crashed, they bailed from the vehicle. Apparently, Service was armed with a knife. It's when he ignored orders to drop that knife that officers then opened fire on him. Seconds later, apparently Don Pfister picked up that knife. That's when she was shot as well. The information today, it helps to answer some of her parents' questions.
For the life of me, I just don't understand why they had to go to that extreme.
Repeatedly shooting his stepdaughter Dawn Pfister and her boyfriend Matthew Service. MnDOT traffic cameras show the couple died where they fell.
Why can't they come out and say if they had one, had a weapon, had not have a weapon, what was the just cause of this?
Sources tell us they did have a sharp object of some kind.
We're going to have a crime scene out here.
A scene with only a handful of witnesses, mainly the officers involved, because the deadly ordeal happened where the highway was closed off. Mylon Masson is a law enforcement professor at a local college. She said the officers who fired their weapons were likely interviewed immediately afterward, and after 5 days to decompress, were brought back to the BCA Wednesday for more questions.
They're going to ask them how did they get involved? Why did they get on the call? What was the reason for the original call? What did you see?
Agents are reviewing footage from traffic cameras, video from squad cars to help fill in the blanks, like how many bullets were fired from whose gun and why. Pfister's family has their own concerns.
One of the things we're just trying to figure out, why is there so much silence about this? Why is there nothing being said?
Why do you think it's good that this case has been hushed?
Because you're not getting rumors. They are looking for the facts, which is really the most important thing.
Again, here is another look at the names of the four officers that were involved in this very high incident on Highway 12. Sergeant Brady Jewell, Officer Trent Wirtz, Trooper Mark Lund, and Corporal Nathan Mueller. They are all veteran officers with experience in law enforcement anywhere from 9 years up to 17 years. As you heard earlier, they are on paid administrative leave, which is standard in situations like this, because just like anybody else would be, these officers are also given the due process of the law. Now, once the BCA completes its investigation, that information will be turned over to the Hennepin County Prosecutor's Office simply for a review, kind of a second set of seasoned eyes to look at a case like this. We also asked Dawn Pfister's family about any services they might have planned for her. A memorial service is planned for February 22nd. Reporting live in St. Paul, Beth McDonough, 5 Eyewitness News.
And we did a quick check of our own news archives, and we learned that one of the officers was honored for his heroic efforts back in 2001. Chaska Officer Brady Jewell was honored for his role in saving several people from a burning apartment building. He and another officer crawled through the building and broke a window to get people out, and even caught a woman who jumped to escape the flames. Now, we learned a lot today. Still, though, questions remain, and you can always count on us for continuing coverage as this story develops.